Jesus loves the little children, all the children of the world. Red and yellow, black and white, they are precious in his sight. Jesus loves the little children of the world. Wonderful. How are you today? My name is Uncle Godfrey, and I'm going to be telling you a story. And our story comes from Luke chapter 5, verse 17 to 26. Luke chapter 5, verse 17 to 26. Right, before I tell you the story, I have something here that I'm holding. If you're looking at this from home, you can see that I'm carrying a model of a hand. Now, I would want to find out from you, my friends, what do we use our hands for? What do we use our hands for? And I definitely know you are so excited. You want to respond. You probably want to tell me. Vuyo says, we use our hands for washing. Nobandile has this to say. She says, we use our hands for writing. Isn't that correct? Yes. Dumi has this to say. We use our hands for cooking. Simpiwe says, we help others with our hands. Ntogozo says, I love touching, so I use my hands to do what? To touch. Now, if we go to our chapter of the day, Luke chapter 5, verse 17, we find a story there. One day, a few friends realized that their friend was not feeling well. He wasn't feeling well such that he wasn't able to move. He could not touch, he could not walk, and therefore the friends decided to help their friend. They heard that Jesus was around and Jesus could heal. So what did they decide to do? They made a mat, took their friend, placed him on a mat, and decided to walk to where Jesus was. Now, when they got to the place where Jesus was, what did they find, my friends? They discovered that a lot of people were around Jesus, and therefore they could not be able to get to where Jesus was. So what did they do? They decided to carry their friend to the roof of the house. They decided to carry their friend to the roof of the what? Of the house. And as they were walking, I can imagine what they were thinking. I can imagine one of them starting a song and saying, step by step, step by step, I will follow Jesus Christ. Because they were going on, they were what? They were moving on the steps. So as they got to the top, they decided to remove the tiles. One by one, they took the tiles. One by one, they took the tiles. And as they took the tiles off from the roof, dust then fell onto the people that were seated around Jesus. And I can see them looking up. I can hear them making noise. What's happening? What's happening? What's happening? Who's doing that? Dust is falling on us. And some were even dusting themselves because they were being made dirty by the dust that was falling off from the roof. Jesus kept quiet. He simply looked at the friends and admired their faith. As they lowered the sick friend down to Jesus, Jesus looks lovingly at this friend who wasn't feeling well. And he says to him, verse 20, Luke chapter 5, verse 20. When Jesus saw their faith, he said, friend, your sins are forgiven. Your sins are forgiven. You can imagine the joy that the friends felt. they had been able to do what? To help their friend. What is Uncle Godfrey saying to you today? Uncle is saying, what is it that we do with our hands? Are we able to use our hands to help others who are not able? I'm thinking of a friend who is on a wheelchair. He wants to cross the streets, and you are there and you're just looking at them. Why don't you today say it in your heart, little boys and girls, I am going to be Jesus' hands to help others. I'm so happy because I know right now someone at home wants to stand with me or wants to pray with me. They want to pray with Uncle. Yes, we want to say a prayer. We want to pray so that we can be Jesus' hands on earth while he is in heaven. Remember, one day soon he is going to come and take us all home. What is it that we are going to do for Jesus? We want to pray now. We want to pray. Our eyes are closed. Our eyes are closed. I know there are some of you who want to pray with me. We are praying. Our Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ, we are so happy. We are so happy for this wonderful story that comes to us, a story that is encouraging us to be Jesus' hands on earth. Help us, O Lord, so that we can be able to assist others. There are so many children out there who need us to be their helpers, to be the helping hands. Guide us, O Lord, and protect us as we grow, as we mature spiritually. Be our guide and our leader. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.